the show. I, Mary Joan. America's favorite comedy show. Starring America's queen of comedy, Joan Davis, as Mrs. Joan Stevens. And featuring Jim Backus as Judge Bradley Stevens.
Brad.
Yes, dear?
I'm sure glad that you agreed to dig up the garden for the new shrubbery instead of going to play golf.
So am I, dear.
I just have one more picture to hang, and then I'll get your lunch.
It's locked.
Stand back, Brad.
Now, wait.
Sue. Honey, I'm going to break it open. Maybe there's jewels or gold hidden away.
Oh, no, honey. I don't think Mr. Robbins left anything in that safe.
Mr. Robbins?
Yes, the man we bought the house from. I'll tell you what, dear. I'll call him, get the combination, and then we'll open the safe, huh?
All right, Brad.
All right, there. See.
Gee, you know, it's funny that Mr. Robbins didn't say anything about the safe in the wall.
Well, he probably forgot all about it. Hello, Mr. Robbins. This is Judge Stevens. Say, can I trouble you for the combination of that safe? What's that? No, the wall safe in the living room.
Yeah, it's right over there.
No, it's behind a panel right over the fireplace.
Yeah, you hit it and it opened up and then you hit it again.
I see. Uh-huh.
What's he saying, Brad?
Well, really.
What's he saying, honey?
Well, that's very interesting.
Well, what's interesting?
is that so? You don't say.
Well, what don't he say, Brad?
Well, thank you very much for telling me. Not at all. Goodbye, Mr. Robbins.
What did you say? Tell me, Robbins, say.
Oh, dear, it was nothing important. How would you like to go to the movies tonight?
Bradley J. Stevens, will you please stop torturing me? Tell me what Mr. Robbins said.
Well, Mr. Robbins didn't even know the safe was there.
He didn't?
No, he said it was probably put in by the original owner, the man he bought it from, Mr. Abner Cartwright.
Gee, then I'll bet that the safe is loaded with stuff.
Well, hardly. You see, Mr. Cartwright was once a rich man, but when he died, his entire estate consisted of this house.
Well, what happened to all his money?
Well, nobody knows. He had no family, no heirs, and Mr. Cartwright was an eccentric old man.
I'll bet I know the reason that they didn't find the money is because it's all in that safe. And it's all ours.
Look, in the first place, you couldn't possibly break open that safe with that hammer.
Oh, that's right. But I'm sure going to try, Brad.
And secondly, if there was anything, I'm not sure it belonged to us.
Now, Brad, how can you possibly say that? We bought this house. That means that we bought everything that's in it. And you said yourself that Mr. Cartwright didn't leave any heirs.
Well, Joni, it's hardly that simple. You see, there has to be a member from the probate court here when that safe is opened.
Then we can keep the money? Then we can keep the money.
Wait. Don't you see? It all depends upon how long ago he died. We might get a percentage of it. We might get nothing. I don't know. It all depends on the circumstances.
Yeah. Maybe you're right. I guess I was getting all excited over nothing. Perhaps there's nothing in the safe.
Now you're being sensible, dear.
It's probably empty. Like you say, a few old letters, photographs.
That's right, dear.
Or at best, maybe Mr. Cartwright just kept a small amount of money in there for emergencies. $100 or so.
That's possible.
Oh, if we're real lucky, some small securities, probably worth very little by now.
Perhaps nothing.
On the other hand, they may have gone up. Mr. Cartwright had invested $1,000 in some oil stock 50 years ago. Today, it could be worth $10,000.
Oh, Joni.
Or maybe even $50,000.
Now, Joni.
Or it could be $500,000. Or even $1,000,000. Brad, $1,000,000. We're rich, Brad.